getting it ready to play in that favourite area of his around about the gully region. And
so you wouldn't really say that McGrath is softening up Kallis. What he's doing is getting his mind onto something different from the main thing.
Shane Warne straight around the wicket to Kallis. Interesting ploy, obviously a plan the Australians have come up with.
Ow!
I can imagine it went down a treat with Mark Waugh.
Actually got a few words out of Mark Waugh when he went round the wicket like this. Mark didn't enjoy this too much, but... Well, he was saying before this test match that still, even a couple of days out from the test match, that he was no certainty of playing. And the reason was that it was this sort of shot that he had trouble with. It wasn't so much playing with a straight bat, it was working the ball square the wicket on the offside and also the onside when he rolls the wrist the other way and works the ball to the onside, which he does very well. That's when he finds he has a problem with the elbow.
Dramatic over and feel for Siddle, 63 for one.
Getting out of a bit of uneven bounce. See that one through low, one to Kallis, flew through quickly. It's 68 for one, really, from this end.
Goes to Kallis.
Men clad in white dotted around the outfield as Peter Siddle steams in from the Old Ford end of the ground, searching for that uneven bounce around off stump that caused Kallis problems when he first arrived at the crease. Ponting still aggressive with his three slips and a gully, and the Australians still pretty chatty out there. We can pick up a lot of the verbals on the stump mic as they look to lift each other, trying to keep that intensity and that sense of purpose out in the middle. It's very easy for a cricket team on a hot day over a long period where they haven't taken a wicket, and this partnership's now worth 88 from 155 balls.
He's a tryer, Peter Siddle.
Tremendous boost for South Africa if they can save this match, because that'll mean they go into the Cape Town test match with something to play for.
Yeah, their efforts today certainly will give them some heart. It's just energy. That's gutsy from Hilfenhaus this late in the day, trying to get some life with a soft ball out of a docile pitch.
It's a big day for this young Australian bowling attack, it particularly having chosen only three specialists. He did a couple of things. He ignited the innings after Neil McKenzie's trenchant effort to see off the new ball.
He's struggling with his line.
He
last delivery was pretty much his stock delivery a little while ago with the older ball, just staying patient outside the off stump, moving it away from the right-hander.
By his own admission, he only wants to use the in-swinger when he's got it right. And certainly there were times yesterday where he mixed up, if you like, his bowling of the past year and a half with attempts at the in-swinger, and it did make him a little more inconsistent. So I guess one assumed today he'd go back to just angling it across the right-handers. Like that, I mean, relentless around that area, and with his subtle changes of pace, he's bowled good cutters, he's bowled good slower balls.
Good judgment by Jacques Kallis.
Conventional with Kallis on strike. Could leave. He seemingly has it in his mind. He will not be tempted. He's, look at that body language. He's almost in a bubble. They talk about Kallis getting in the bubble, and he hasn't been tempted thus far to play a drive at all. Everything this morning has been off the back foot, a little knock here and there, worked off the hip, and the one half volley he got on his pads he punched away. But offside, deep backward square leg, the offside is conventional. There he is, and under the scoreboard.
Just get to a situation, if Australia continue to bowl so well and not give away runs, that South Africa's attention might turn to trying to save the match. They've been kept pretty quiet this morning. That's under two runs and over. That new ball, it can go if bowlers bowl badly. That can bring on runs. But if this pattern continues, suddenly things might be out of reach for South Africa in terms of winning.
Yeah, well, at this point I think what's happened is that South Africa will be looking to get to lunch now, not further scathed.
These are the times when you think back to the first innings and realize how important the first innings of a test match is. If you don't bat well in the first innings, this is invariably what you're faced with. Siddle has operated full and a good length primarily, and the odd bouncer just to push the batsman back and let him know that he's around with these fearsome stares. These situations that teach you about playing well in the first innings, because it's not fun having to come out here on day five and survive or try and win the match. Learn to value your wickets at this level, because you don't want to spend your career playing test cricket like this.
Kept pretty low. They'll scamper through for a bye. Mitchell Johnson, 1 for 76 in the second innings to go with his 4 for 25 in the first. Here he comes and goes to Kallis. Starts with a bouncer.
Ricky Ponting will feel good about what's happened so far this morning. He'll feel even better if he can get another wicket before lunch. They've rallied well, bowled well, better than they did yesterday afternoon, the Australians.
temper seems to waver, skills level increase.
That's excellent bowling now.
Good pace, his line's good, he's getting some movement. He's using the new ball well.
Tried to drive a wide delivery and has dragged it on, and that is the big one for Australia.